We've had lots of great action, but the first series we'll be casting today will be between Ghost User and Heart. It's going to be a battle between two team members from Complexity.
Yeah, Zerg versus Terran. And I think the big favorite going into this is actually Heart. Of course, yeah, we can say the Korean. But Ghost User is one of these North American players that are under the radar, training it up as much as possible in the Complexity house. And I think this is a good sort of debut for his skill to really test him and see if he's capable of playing at that high-level play.
Yeah, it's really cool because Ghost User used to be one of these guys that played, you know, like at the really high level of GM but never able to break onto the pro scene. And then Complexity Academy gave him a chance. He's been able to work his way up from the B team to the A team, the only person to actually do so, proving that the Academy can work, training up-and-coming North American players. Of course, Ghost User is a Zerg player and Heart is a Terran player, so it's going to be a classic struggle between Zerg versus Terran. We'll see if Ghost User has it on our first map of the day, which will be between these two players on Entombed Valley.
Entombed Valley, one of the tougher maps for Zerg versus Terran. Taking the third is exceptionally hard. We'll go into that as the game progresses, though. It definitely depends on how these two players actually do their build orders.
All right, let's introduce our players, Andre. Starting in the top left from Team Complexity, we have Ghost User. Not Gowser. Everyone calls him Gowser.
Gosswer.
Gosswer. Actually, that's how, I mean, I used to cast him back when you did online cups. I used to say stuff like that, like Gausswer. I didn't know how to pronounce it. But,
it's a W.
I know. That's actually what's really clever. It's two U's.
I like that. W. I definitely like that.
Over in the bottom right, we have Heart from Team Complexity. One of the... Actually, for a while, he was a mainstay in MLG tournaments, whether it was arenas or in the championship series, and since then has kind of been falling off. A lot of people said that Heart's kind of a cheesy player. He's kind of a player that relies a lot on coin flipping, in a sense. But at the same time, Heart's more than capable of playing macro. There's just one of these games I remember against DRG in the Winter Championships on Antigua Shipyard. It was game number 3, I believe, where Heart played incredible macro. But he's not really up to that just yet. He's placing his first barracks slightly off of his bottom of his natural ramp. And we've been seeing Terrans going for two racks on this map quite often. I'm wondering if Heart's going to go for two racks or just try to, you know, make Ghost User a little bit uncomfortable.
It'll be so unfortunate if he goes two racks. And it looks like he is going to. And look at this. Drone is not going to go across the I thought for sure the drone and the SCV would meet up. But look at that. The barracks is going to be over here. Very interesting position. But still... I think Ghost User, because he's in cross position, he should be able to defend this pretty accurately.
Yeah, I mean, it does give him a lot of distance. And, of course, we did see this last time we were here, Andre, when Scarlet was up against the two racks. And it's just a little bit difficult because of the way the ramp works. It's a very narrow ramp. You can kind of place a bunker to behind the minerals as well. You know, it's just a very, very tough area for Zerg to defend if they don't respond to it. But Ghost User does end up seeing the first barracks. Or actually, this is the second barracks, but he doesn't know about it.
Well, here's the thing. This should be a little bit suspicious because this is like 5 seconds. Seconds to 10 seconds, a little bit late. So this is like, is this the second racks or not? You have to be really in tune with your timings if you actually want to know that that happened. Right now, as we speak, the first SEV is coming out here. And look at this. Ghost User is aware of what is possible. He puts his drone directly over here and he says, okay, I have to be careful because there could still be a two racks. Yeah. There's no immediate command center. Let's go ahead and play it super safe.
Yeah, he's trying to prevent any kind of tucking against that wall. You can kind of trap your Marine against the ramp that way. So Ghost User being very comprehensive in how he deals with this for now. You can see a few SCVs are being pulled as well. There's a total of 6 out into the field, 4 Heart away from this mineral line. And will Heart be able to get up the bunkers? You see that Ghost User starts his spine crawler immediately, which is what he needs to do, but even then, he still has a long way to go before he's safe.
Oh, beautiful, though. 6 Zerglings going to pop out. This is a very early spawning pool. These Zerglings have to be careful. Excuse me. Doing a good job to stop any additional Marines from going forward, and he's protecting the Spinecrawler efficiently. You might see...
It's getting very tight. The Spinecrawler wants to go up as soon as possible, but taking a lot of damage. And what's interesting is that Heart's been able to really do this even without establishing a bunker. And I think he's just going to send his SCVs back on home and keep pressuring, which is a good move. But for now, Ghost User seems to be safe.
Beautifully played by Ghost User. He was able to get the Spinecrawler up. Once you get the Spinecrawler, it doesn't necessarily mean that you're okay, but you're in a good position. Now the big thing is, how do you check if this is going to be a continued all-in? Will there be 2 more command centers that go down directly after this? Or is it going to be 4 racks SCV all in. And that's why Ghoster User doesn't really have the capabilities of knowing either of the two, so he has to protect himself against the all in. He will be putting down probably at least another Spinecrawler after this.
That's right. He doesn't have Overlords in position to spot his opponent's expansion or potential not expansion. You can see that Ghoster User is placing a second Spinecrawler just to be extra safe. There's about 9-10 Marines right outside of his ramp as well, so he's just being very safe because it's very easy for Marines to just run all over that one Spinecrawler, and all of a sudden, because you didn't take it seriously, you're in trouble. And look at this, Ghoster User is placing a Roachhorn immediately as well, taking it very seriously at this point.
You have to. The other alternative actually is to go Banelings. Banelings is a little bit tougher because you have to wait for that Metabolic Boost to actually come out so that you surround all the units. You also need to be pretty larva intensive. It requires so much, and if you're wrong, you just wasted a ton right there. As we speak, Hart is going ahead and backing up with all of his units. You can see the nice wall off with the barracks. Everything is playing out pretty standard after two racks. A lot of mind games always ensues in these positions.
Yeah, and at this point, I mean, what is your real options from Hart? Did he do enough damage, Andre? I mean, what is your opinion on Hart's opening? Is he okay here economically?
You know, it's kind of tough to say. He is a little bit ahead, but I don't know how much this Roach attack will actually do. I really feel like this Roach attack is a little ill-fated. It's very difficult to actually do anything against, let's say, bunkers. Even if two are down, you know your opponent has been really, really splurging on a ton of Marines. So I think doing this attack is really tough, especially when you don't have Metabolic Boost. I think Hart, for the progression directly after this, is in a great position.
All right, so you can see that Hart does spot the first few Roaches onto the field, which gives him some very important intel. You can see that he's also going for a second Tech Lab, so he's going to start double upgrades very soon, or potentially squeeze out Marauders if he feels very unsafe. And with that, Hart's going to be able to be pretty secure for now. And oh, look at, I like this very early engineering bay as well to start plus one. And of course, a lot of Zergs have been trying to play greedy in terms of their upgrades, get it very early, and the earlier Terran starts their upgrades makes them very sound in the mid-game.
But the fact of the matter is, with the Roaches already out, you actually have a good progression. Roach, Zergling, Baneling is super cost efficient, funny enough, against Marine Marauders. Actually, Zergling, Baneling is really efficient. The Roaches are going to help just because you can tank a little bit more. But if he loses all of his Roaches, that's a big problem. Ghoster User going to try to kite as best as possible, but I really feel like any attacks are super silly in this position. Especially, you know, natural progressions after two racks, it's going to favor a lot of bio.
Yeah, and Bio is cleaning up the rest of these Roaches, really, and Ghoster User poked back in just to get a sense of their unit composition. But at this point, Hart is just more than comfortable in just making units, now also starting combat shields and teching up to Factory, finally, knowing that, you know, Ghoster User wasn't really intending on going for any kind of Roach Bane bust. Mm-hmm. Now he can back off and really macro from here.
You can definitely see, though, the Roaches being made are affecting his economy so much. 39 to 40 at this point.
He's still making more, too.
And he was at a time where he just could not spend the larva. It was very unfortunate. Of course, he supply blocked, but there's a series of things when you get two queens out super, super early and you don't have the economy to actually hold that. You're in a lot of trouble. Here we go. The first major engagement is going to happen right here. Metabolic Boost is not finished. And it looks like that third base.
Yeah.
Base is under serious threat.
Both these are... Oh, a Spinecrawler moving way too far out, trying to move his way to the third base. Instead, he gets caught. Both players have pretty much low upgrades for both of their armies. I mean, Stim just finished. Metabolic Boost will finish as well. And that's pretty much the only thing going into this fight. So both players will have to just utilize their micro. But this is a great position for Hart and phenomenal time to really shut it down. Ghoster User's economy is not that strong. A huge Stim as well from Hart's army. He's going to clean up the rest of these units very easily. And Ghoster User has pretty much nothing left. He's only has drones and queens left, Andre.
Plus one and combat shields finished just as that engagement happened.
Oh, wow.
Ghoster User in a terrible position, almost an unwinnable position as well. He needs something huge. The Baneling Nest is now being started. He doesn't even have evolution chambers up on the field. You can see this plus one attack is really going to kick in and help out Hart so much. Ghoster User now going to take his third base again. But the damage has been done. I mean, really, there's every single transition that Hart can do, and he won't be stopped. I mean, he's going into Medivacs. That's great. I mean, that's going to keep his Marines and Marauders alive that much more.
Yeah, the big thing is that he's been able to retain his units. So even though that, you know, he did lose a few and he took some damage, the fact is when medevacs come out, he'll be able to have more aggression opportunities. While Ghost User lost a lot, he lost his army, he lost some of his static defense, lost his hatchery. At this point, Ghost User's drone count is just very weak. It's at 46 at this point, and he doesn't really have anything else. He's starring upgrades, but that just means he wants to carry the game a little bit longer. But yeah, how much longer can you really play this macro game? Hearts' third is already done on its way.
Yeah, and if you look back at things right now, Frodan, I mean, that Roach attack in the beginning basically did as much as if you did absolutely nothing. So obviously, there is no like embedded Roach timing right there. You should really just drone up, try to get the economic advantage, and play from that. I understand where Ghost User was going with that. Heart, as you were talking about in the beginning, is a lot more aggressive. He has a play-to-win mentality. So I guess Ghost User was saying, okay, he's a lot more inclined to do an all-in. Let's go Roaches and really hard counter that. But it's unnecessary. It's really unnecessary, in my opinion.
Well, Heart does have a pretty nice timing right before a lot of important upgrades like Gleer of Constitution and Centrifugal Hood's finish, as well as +1/+1. So this is the time for Heart to strike as soon as +1 armor finishes as well. Heart's going to go ahead and stim. No Banelings there to assist in attacking the Marines, and all the Roaches are absolutely crushed by the Terran army. And Heart just has a great opportunity here to take out the third. Yet again, the Banelings are finishing up, but it doesn't even matter because Heart just has way too much stuff.
Upgrades are larger, as you were talking about. Positioning is better. GG gets called out. Ghost User taps. And we have our 1-0 victory over for Heart.
Mm-hmm. What do you know? GG button. Not yet. I'm waiting for the most epic games for the GG button. That'll be our little off-season
thing. Well, why don't you
tell
everybody what the GG button is?
GG button is it's an easy button. But instead of typing or saying that was easy, you say GG in the Korean way.
Won't press it again. Anyway, that's that. Heart will take game number one after kind of a successful mind game from two racks.
Lots of high-level mind games and psychological games. We'll see if Ghost User will be able to come back in this series. It's a best of three, guys. We'll be back after a quick commercial break.